Alright guys, welcome back to Silent Hill 3. Oh, we're seemingly in hell. Or something. I mean, it's obviously the other side of the hospital. But look how fucking bright red it is. What the hell? So we have some crossed out. I missed six, but I don't care. There's probably nothing in it. Go in this room. I didn't even look and see what it was. Where is this? Examining room 4. There's a dead body hanging from the ceiling. The blood dripping from it has totally filled the bucket set out below. Who would do this and for what? It looks like a full out blood letting. Yeah. Weird. Let me see something. We're on 5 when I turned it up the first time. Is it any better? Maybe slightly. All right, so we're in the day room. Elevator, special treatment room. Special treatment room. I hear something weird. No other door. Oh God. That was weird. Can't. 1, 2, 3 is what I can see. I don't know what these are. What are these? Can't really see him. Should I click one? Doesn't work. The button looked like it had 32. Is there a phone inside of this locker?
Leonard?
That's the murderer's name, not my name. I'm not your beloved Stanley either. He's underground now. His new name is Number 7.
Okay.
But don't worry about that now. It's time to celebrate your birthday.
You've got me mistaken for someone else. Today's not my...
I'm not mistaken. Today is your 24th birthday. And I have a present for you. Which do you prefer? To give pain or to receive it? You can have the one you hate the most. Happy birthday to you!
Like how there's a payphone in the locker.
It's not my birthday.
Honestly, to me, it's creepier and you know, scarier and stuff when there aren't so many enemies around. Plastic bag. Health. There's no important trash I'm not even around. Okay. Oh, hello. Right there. I bet you we have to use that bag over there. So we can go through the day room, because I don't know if that door is unlocked, so I think we might have to go through the day room. To unlock it from that side. Where's the door? Oh, whoops. A totally ordinary transparent plastic bag. This is from a trash can in the locker room. Put the blood in the plastic bag. Plastic bag with blood. Why we need it? I don't know. I've put the blood from the treatment room in this. I don't especially want to carry it around with me. We have to for right now. I think I'm gonna have to go back, yeah, through the day room to the elevator. Been to 1, 2, and 3. We haven't been to every door, but there's so many enemies. Whatever these are, we can do these. That one. I don't know. Something 3. I have no idea. I guess they're ones that aren't on the map. Weird. 8, 4, 5, 9, 0, 6, 2, 1, 3. Oh, it's just like 1 through 7. I bet you it has something to do. Maybe we got to enter only the ones with the blood. What's this? I don't know. It's a person. One, two, three, and four. So 1 through 4. There's 4 of these that are covered. 6, 8, 4, and 7. But where would I put the code in to? So you don't grab any of these, I don't think, do you? No. Oh, there's a fucking thing right here. So it's going to be 7. Alright guys, so I think I get it. So the gurneys that are next to each other is going to be 1 and 4. So it's going to be 8-4, which I already have. Oh wait, but no, it's not. Or maybe it's 4-8 then. Cause I've just been trying codes with these four numbers. Maybe it's 8-4 or 4-8. Damn it, I passed it. Cause it has to be 4-8-6-7 for 8-7-6. What? Cause the number is 7. Yeah, there's no numbers over here. 7, 6, 8, and 4. On the mural thing, the 1 through 4, 1 and 4. Maybe it's not how it is? I guess these also could be next to each other. Well, three of them are like right across, are right next to each other. Oh, okay. What's hard is, so we know that the third one is the one that's off by itself. We know that the third one is 6. Not that. So if we know if that one's 6. Just try a few of these. The 7, 8, and 4. Oh, got it. Okay. Whew. Oh my god. It wasn't like the hardest thing, but what was hard was knowing. Knowing the. The order, right? Cremated key. Oops. Cremated key. I found this in some sort of crematorium underground. It's burned black, but still usable. Well, we haven't been to the first floor yet. That lock is just so I can unlock it on the other side. It has to be because you can just walk around. Yeah, let's go to the first floor and see. Alright. I mean, so far, like, the puzzles have been very, very good in the sense of like, holy shit, this is hard to figure out sometimes. Like, that one wasn't too hard to figure out. It was just placing in the order. And I probably could have done it a lot easier. But sometimes I'd be done. Oh shit. Oh. Oh, shit. Health-wise, I have no idea. Okay, I was fine. But you see what I mean with, like, even with the flashlight, I can't fucking see anything. Full of dirty syringes in the bed. Not sure about you. I'm not about to use them, that's for sure. There's a memo here on the chart. Dr. Midkiff. Please use extra caution with the patient in room 312. He should still have his religious freedom here in the hospital, but he shouldn't push his faith on others. I'm a victim too. Rumor has it he got here by stabbing someone over a religious dispute. Please be careful. R. Crosby. Oops. P.S. It looks like the rumor's true. According to the head nurse, I do think he's a good person. Otherwise, though, easy to deal with. I don't know what else is over here. I'm just going towards the biggest room. Oh, that's what used the key on. I was gonna say there has to be something in here. I'm trying to remember if there's anything said about something. We could just go into C1, 2, 3, 4, see if there's anything. Thank you. think that's... I don't like that. Only because when there's like... Motherfucker. Oh, I'm kicking it. I didn't mean to kick it. Oh, was that what the dude was talking about? Oh shit. Motherfucker. Alright. Come on. I pressed the select button 7 times. Oh, I don't have any more ammo for this gun. That sucks. Put the shotgun on. Really? Did you really miss? Point blank. I love it. You can't shoot them when they're in certain animations for some reason. It's so stupid. Back to that, I guess. Staring at something. Something on the platform. It's too thin to be a person. I don't think I'll go so far as to pull off the sheets and check. Yeah. Probably a good idea. Oh. Health, first aid. Are these birthday presents? Well, I guess I shouldn't look a gift horse in the mouth. Besides, if I didn't really need this stuff right now, he wouldn't have given it to me. That weirdo, I mean. Yeah, but... what's this? There's something on the ground. Is this a birthday card? Happy 38th birthday. 14 plus 7 plus 17 is 38. But it's not my birthday. Is that gonna be... oh, so I only have 11 shotgun shells. I have 64 submachine gun bullets, 12 stun guns, no other things. Should I write down that note? Oh wait, what is that? Whoever wrote this must be trying to tell me something. 14 plus 7 plus 17. Okay, I've got that wrote down. Must be trying to tell me something. Oh shit. Oh shit. Not only how fucking dark it is, but constant things are just in your fucking way. Like, there's something in front of me that I cannot see. And since I don't know where to go, save point. There's a stretcher here. Not just your usual stretcher, this is more like an altar of some sort. Lit candles, a knife, and is that blood I smell? Did they worship that picture or something in the picture? Yeah, let's save it. Saw that drawn on the dividing screens at the hospital. But this is different. Seems like it was drawn a long time ago, somehow. But because of that, like, I can't see where anything is. Like, the ones that are red and crawling on the floor, you can't see them unless they're right at you. The same with the nurses, because they're just white. And it's not like they glow in the black, you know. So it's like... The title is Lost Memories. One characteristic mentioned only in rare documents and dying out in the modern age is that of the ritual sacrifice. Offering prayers, pierce a man's chest with a copper stake, drench the altar in the blood which spouts red from the heart, to praise and to show loyalty unto God. In another sacrificial rite mentioned in the same book, the victim is burned alive, which was a more dignified ceremony in which prisoners and sinners were not allowed to participate. Only the clergy could be sacrificed. Similar to burning at the stake, no comparable rite can be found in religions practiced nearby. It may have some connection with the main deity being a sun god. Even though this religion extols redemption, it brings to mind a dark and cultish history. Right. So the blood, so do we empty the bag? And like right now, because my room is so red, I do not know how much health I have. The only indication I know is because my controller isn't vibrating. Okay, that is what you do.
Leonard, where are you?
Thank you. Now I can finally leave here. Now Claudia's ridiculous dream is over. Well, I guess it's time to dispose of her. The salvation of all mankind. Ha! Why must we reward even the unbelievers?
What are you talking about?
About our plans. It's true that God is merciful, but first, one must be chosen. Only we, who hearken to the voice of God, will be given the keys to paradise. Don't you think so?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead and think whatever you want.
What do you mean by that?
I mean that I don't think the way you guys do. I don't want any part of that kind of paradise.
You're an unbeliever. You deceived me.
I didn't deceive you. We were both just wrong about each other. I thought you were a normal person.
So you tried to trick me so you can run off with my seal, eh? Heretic! You plan to destroy God!
I told you, I wasn't trying to trick anyone. What is this seal thing anyway?
Don't play innocent. You can't fool me anymore. The seal is mine. I was appointed by God to be its guardian. The only thing you'll get from me is a gruesome death.
Yes.
Well, I guess you're not a person anyway.
That was weird. I'll tell you what. I'll take this. Oh, I had to reload. No idea where he is. Our health is still okay, though. That hurts. I can't see a fucking thing. This is our last bit of shotgun shells. I can't run. Oh yeah. Really? Oh, that was okay. That wasn't too bad.
Leonard's not here anymore. I guess I should head back to the motel now.
Okay.
I hope Douglas is okay. Huh? What? What's this?
A talisman. Oh, I have coasters that look exactly like that. That's pretty cool. It has an old Ada design inscribed on it. I got it after I defeated Leonard. Alright, so that means we can leave. And we are on the first floor, so we gotta go all the way to the right. Yeah, it's kind of funny. So the second game, I had way more, I had way more ammo than I do in this one. And health, I think, at this point. But with this one, even if I had all of that health and ammo, like I was saying, because it's just
so... Why did you send her to my father?
Was that wrong?
It's your
fault
that
he... The fuck is this?
Oh,
but surely it's a good thing. It means he was one of God's beloved, no?
Those who mock God will never receive salvation. You'll go to hell, Vincent. You'll never feel the joy of God's everlasting paradise.
And you think God is going to save you? Ha!
What do you know anyway?
I know about the pleasures of this world. And I want to find my happiness while I'm still here. You hated your father, didn't you? I saw the way he hit you, kicked you, and made you cry. The memory of his cruelty is forever burned into my mind.
Yes, yes. And that's why we need God.
What you call faith is nothing more than a child crying out for love. That's why you're all alone.
You don't understand. None of you do.
What the hell is going on there? But yeah, anyway, because it's so dark, even if I had all of that ammo, can we go? Well, the left is faster anyway. Because it's so dark and it's just, I can't see half the enemies unless they're literally right up on me. And by that time, it's like too late, they're gonna hit you. You know, no matter what at that point. Especially with these, considering that... it seems like whenever they're in any sort of animation, you cannot hit them or shoot them. So weird. I feel like they definitely went... They went way more action heavy on this one. But they didn't give you enough resources to merit it, I want to say. Like, I feel like the second one was way less action heavy, but they gave you, like, a ton of stuff. Like, I think I honestly could have killed most of the enemies and still had enough ammo for the final boss or whatever, you know. Whereas this one, I feel like I have to run past almost everything. Because I just never have enough ammo. And I, like I said, I just can't see where the enemies are. Need to go in 106. Yeah, I'm on the right way.
Where's Douglas?
He went out. But he left a message for you.
Was there someone else here just now?
No, no, just me. Don't you want to know what the message is?
Yeah, what did he say?
The church is on the other side of the lake.
Church? What he meant by that?
You don't understand? That's where Claudia is. Across the lake. On the north side. If you're going, you better go through the amusement park. It's probably the only way in now. Go northwest on Nathan Avenue. It's a bit far. But closer than heaven.
Is that it for the message?
Uh-huh.
Thanks. Douglas really said that?
What's wrong? You don't trust me?
No. You're a weirdo. Okay. Oh, there's an arrow pointing there. Okay. Yeah, just straight up there. That is going to be a long run. And she does, I guess, after the first two, she does seem to get a little tired, like, and slower when if you keep running. Whereas the first two, you could just run at the same speed, and when you stopped, he would get, you know, he would be like, but he would just continuously run the entire time. Whereas here, she does slow down. But the creatures can't get you even if you're slower, so. Unless you're walking, that's the only way they can get you. Okay, we don't have to walk the whole way, thank God. Don't have a map? giant rabbit costume. Isn't this the mascot from the local amusement park? I don't want to look inside. Something in there smells terrible. Yeah, because it's a dead person. It's a map of the amusement park, but I can't bring this with me. I didn't even know this was a door. Oh shit. See, this is what's gonna get me. I can't see anything, and I don't have a map. I was gonna say, it takes her so long to recover from that and turn around. Like, I don't know if... I'm even supposed to be in here. Stuffed animal here. Yeah, I need health and ammo. Oh great, beef jerky. Something I've used one time, and I don't think I'd used it successfully. And pool. I didn't even know that was something. She's not even looking at anything. Oh, never mind. The fuck? Can I now open this? Save. I needed that. Roller coaster key. Again, no map. Right there. Like, I need some indication on where to go when I just can't see anything like this. It's blocks. And then those are like, I can't go anywhere. know this isn't where I go. I know it's somewhere in here, but I cannot see anything to figure it out. And I'm pretty sure I'm like one hit kill. I'm pretty sure this is just the same place I went to. Yeah. Door here. Couldn't see it, of course. And of course, there's shit everywhere. Honestly, couldn't tell that I could open it. Oh. Hello. Yeah, I couldn't avoid him at all. That was nice. Gadget to control a roller coaster. I don't know how to make it work though. There's a power switch on the left hand side. It's been left on. Will you turn it off? Yes. Our house is okay. Man, I really wish there was a save point at this part. Because I don't know, like, I don't want to just jump off and die. And I don't know if going down helps me any. Because there's just things chasing me everywhere. Like, since I can't see if I can jump this. Probably not. Let's just get it. God, these camera angles are turning me around, left and right. Like, why? That goes back out the gate. So I just have no idea. Like, I'm just gonna jump off. We stopped it for a reason. If I die, then fuck it. I mean, I can't see anything. Oh, okay. Where did she jump?
I hired you to find the girl, and you performed serviceably. What is it now?
You lied to me about Heather, lady. I don't like being used.
Lie? What lie?
That Heather was kidnapped from you.
But it's true. She was originally one of us. That man, Harry Mason, stole her away and kept her hidden from us.
Yeah, but she says she was happy.
She was brainwashed by him. Deceived, because her true self had not yet awoken. God within her. But when Alessa, Mother of God, truly awakens.
Yeah? What's gonna happen?
She will usher in the eternal paradise.
What kind of place is that?
A place with no pain, no hunger, no sickness, no old age. There will be no greed or war. And all will live by God's grace alone.
No this, no that, no nothing. A paradise? For castrated sheep, maybe.
sounds pretty boring.
I pity you. You still don't understand. You're going to kill me? Is it really so easy for you?
I've done it before.
Then I truly do pity you.
Okay. I was gonna say, I was like, why isn't the camera following her? We're gonna go ahead and end it there. A little frustrated, it only because of the total darkness. But anyway, hope you guys are enjoying it. Have a good one, and I'll see you in maybe the final part next. Who knows? Bye.